Today, in this Friday sermon, I would like just to highlight few points. Because those, I want to address at least three or four issues, which are all of them are in the issues and the events that are outstanding in this week. Always we have to address what is going on in that week in our world. So in this week, we know we had so many events, holidays, happy days. We were kind of taking break from our hard work, the studies, and we have taken that break because of these holidays. And surprisingly, the holidays that we had today, the major ones are the one that we call the Christmas Day, the 25th of December. So what happened is that on the 25th of December, that one this year coincided another holiday, which was, we call it the Mawlid. Mawlid al-Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as many of us believe in, is that it happened on 25th December, which was last Friday. And the birth of Jesus, as many believe, is also last Friday, 25th December. And today is the first day of the year. So we had 1 week, which has shown so many holidays, and coincidentally, all of them came together. So then, we need to just to shed a light on them, but at the same time, to talk about how can we address them, how can we deal with them. Therefore, I would like first of all to mention about the birth of Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, and peace be upon him. And the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him. And then after that, to look at what can we do with the current situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran many verses that show us on the day that we can, two verses that tells us when our year, calendar year, starts. And Allah told us, we can know then when every month begins. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown us the significance of the months, particularly four of them. And then after that, he told us that how should we manage our timing. And so that is enough education. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله. Indeed, the number of the months in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are 12. يوم خلق السماوات والأرض. And then that date was begun when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first day when he created the heavens and the earth. So the beginning of those days are based on when the heavens and the earth were set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he started the clock. So our clock was set on that day. That's how we calculate our timing. So it's not when somebody was born, it's not when an incident took place, it's just that. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ الْأَرْضِ مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةِ حُرُمٍ ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ. And so there are 4 months which are sacred in these 12 months. How do we know that our year, calendar year, was begun when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set on the structure of the heavens and the earth? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in hadith, which is the last word farewell the last sermon of the Father, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إن الزمان قد استدارك كي أتي يوم خلق السماوات والأرض. Indeed, the era, the time, makes a circle, and that circle goes back to the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the heavens and the earth. So it is a round circle. That circle, it goes back to the origin and then continues from there. But analyzing that hadith and that verse, it has proved it what scientifically was proven recently, which the people of the metaphysics and physics, they discovered that every 1,000 years, some says every 10,000 years, but some says every 1,000 years, that the world, the time goes back to its origin. So that one is very, it's well known, it's called cosmos year. The cosmos year, which is, you can say, every 20 years, every 10 years, or every 1,000 years, it's that way. Then that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered for us in His Quran, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has described it. It's very clear. And compare that with today, which is the first day of January. January, just to be a short, it came to this way that there was a young boy who was born maybe having autism or something like that. His head looked like, if you see him from back, you think that you see his face. And if you see his face, then you think this is his face. So he was having like two faces. Many people are like that. Their head is like this. And you think, whenever you come from behind or from front, you think the person is facing you. Backward and forward, almost close to each other. So a young boy was born like this, and the boy was awaited before he was born, because he was the son of Julius Caesar, the king who was forcing people to worship him. So he said, "If I, the child who is going to come will be your God after I die." So you continue from there. That was his mission. The boy was born. Then they said, "Whoa, this one, now it is because this is miracle, someone who has two faces." It shows that this is the beginning of the year then. We say they decided to say this is the beginning of the year when he was born. Whatever before was the dark side, and whatever comes is the light side. So they made all their houses, the two doors, every house have two doors. You come from the front and you go out from behind. That means when you come from the front, the bad thing goes out from behind, so the two doors. So they say it is the beginning of new life. That's how they have described it. It's the beginning of a new life. So it's to say the day he was born is the day they gave him his name, Janus, which was later on became January, to say this is the time to start the year. And it was enforced by many kings after that, namely king that was called the Conqueror, the John the Bastard. Those are the ones who made it well and highly to be celebrated in the last one. That is one side. So compared between the 2 years, the year of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and this year, that's two comparisons. The comparison between Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wa salam. Some say he was born on 25th December. Actually, everyone who has read the Bible knows that it's not biblical. It's against the Bible. The Bible tells us very clearly that Isa alayhi salam was born in another time, which was summertime, not a winter time, not December 25th. Because if you look at like Luke, Matthew, all of them, they will tell you specifically, start from Luke 13 to 29. They tell you that when Jesus was born, shepherds were watch guarding their sheep outdoors, outside in the night time. So in early hours of the night time, sheep were grassed outside of their houses. That is, it shows when you look at the environment in Palestine, Palestine and that area, it is that if it is winter, nobody can watch God shave any flocks of sheep or people outside the, their houses in that in the winter time. That coincides and it's in conformity with the ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran, in which Allah says, فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَىٰ جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًّا. Allah says, in the case of Maryam, عليها السلام, when فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَىٰ جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ. So the hardship, the difficulties of the childbirth drove her to trunk, balm trunk. So she went to the trunk of the balm tree, and when she went there, she said, قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا. I wish I had died before this happened to me. وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًا. And I became a forgetting person. Would have never been remembered. Because she was giving birth and she was feeling pain. Then Angel Jibril, نَادَاهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا. He cried unto her from her pillow and said to her, don't worry. He said to her, do not be grieved at all. Feel happy. وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِرْءِ النَّخْلَةِ. And shake the palm tree towards you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put, Allah says, first, فَقُلِي فَنَدَى مِنْ تَحْتَى أَلَّا تَحْزَنِي قَدْ جَعَلَ رَبُّكِ تَحْتَكِ سَرِيًّا. Indeed, Allah has put a water stream under you. So you look at the water that's coming to you, you drink it. And then shake the palm tree towards you, and you will see fruit is falling to you. Then, فَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي وَقَرْبِي عَيْنًا. So eat and drink and enjoy. Be comfortable. That shows me that that time, it was a winter time, because the date, the palm trees, all of them are in the summer time. You cannot get date in the winter time because the trees become dry. So this tree was not dry, and she was thirsty, and she was all hungry. If it was cold, she may not feel that thirst. Those two verses, you can see, they can go along together. The one which is in the Bible and the one in the Quran, in Surah Maryam. In all that and the history, it's very clear. Actually, people who have studied the Christianity, they know that very well. It's not in, it's not a kind of disputable issue. Then the problem now we see, it's an issue of how this came. Just to highlight how it came was, it was a compromise between the Roman Catholic and many pagans, pagans who worshipped the sun, the pagans who were worshipping the vegetation, the pagans who were worshipping the moon, and the pagans who were worshipping the fire. Because the Roman Catholic, they wanted to spread Christianity all over the world. And that's why they call it Christmas. You know the meaning of Christmas? It is Christ Mass. But people brought it together and made it longer. It's Christ Mass. Is to make the Christ Mass to the whole world. And then this was an agreement to say, okay, those who were worshipping the sun, we take your day of celebration, which it was 24th December, starting actually from 17th December to 25th December, to say it is the day you celebrate. Because why? It's they believe that is when their God, that they think is their son, has won from the other God that they believe was the moon. So people who were worshipping the moon and those who were worshipping the sun were fighting each other, and the sun worshippers have captured many towns from those who were worshipping the moon. then they celebrate on that day. And the miracle they have seen is that when it is 25 December, from that day on, starting from 26 December, you see the daytime is coming back, minute or 2 minutes after. Minute by minute or 2 by 2 minutes, it's coming back. So they said our God is winning and he's getting back his peace and his life. They said, okay, we have to get our day celebrated. This is a time bring. Others who were worshiping the vegetation, the green, who believed in the evergreen lifestyle, is the pleasure of life. They said, okay, they were worshiping a tree, which is the one we call the Christmas tree. That tree, they were worshiping at that time, and it's written in the Bible that pagans were worshiping a tree before Jesus, alayhi salam. So they said, our tree must be also there to be in this celebration. They accepted, okay, bring your tree also. Others who were worshiping the fire, they said, okay, what about our God, who is the fire? We have to get the fire in our in this celebration, which is in the event of this agreement. They said, okay, bring the candle. We see even our meetings always, we naturally become to have a candle. That candle is the fire worshippers. And it is very common in, it's called Nairuz. Those of you who came from like Greek, Iran, all that, it's well known, the Nairuz day. Then this is based on agreement between the celebration is called Mitra, the Saturnalia, Paternalia. All of them, they came together and they made this agreement, these days to be the holidays, and then the Catholic said, okay, let's call it Christmas because it is the day when Christianity was spread. That's how it came. What about, we need to be fair, what about the birthday of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before I go to that, nobody knows when Jesus alayhi salatu wa sallam was born. Nobody was recording it. So nobody knows. That is impossible. But most probably it was a summertime around March and April that time. What about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Nobody knows when he was born. Nobody can say he was born. So last week, last Friday, it was Rabiul Awwal 12 Rabiul Awwal. Many people celebrated. They say this is when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. But nobody knows. He himself didn't know when he was born. And he never told us. Actually, it is the opposite. It's when he died. So that's when he died. They are celebrating for his death. And one thing to mention is that the celebration of 25th December, the birthday of Jesus, alayhi salatu wasalam, as said, and Rabi'ul Awwal, 12, and to celebrate for the birthday of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, both of them began from Egypt. So the origin of these birthdays are from the from Egypt of today, where the worshippers of the trees began from Lebanon. That's why up to now Lebanon has the flag in the that tree. So all came from that area. Therefore, it was all customs, human customs, traditional. So attitude, even the birthday of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's not Quranic, it's not Sunnah, it is especially because some of people become jealous of the Christians celebrating for the birthday of Jesus alayhi wa sallam. They said we must do. Those were called Fadimiyin in Egypt. So they did that, and it was strengthened and spread by Mustafa Kemal Atatürk of Turkey. So the birthday of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has no place at all, as the birthday of Jesus alayhi wa sallam has no place also. All of them are traditions, customs. Then what should we do? And the New Year, we see it is based on somebody's birthday and who was deemed as a god by some people who were pagans. You can see all the situation that we are in. In a in a kind of abyss, in a hole where, in a hole where there is nothing. We are in vacuum. We don't have something clear at all. But then, what is the solution? And inshallah, in the next part of the khutbah, I will mention what the solution could be. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, this is now we see we live in this environment where people have different opinions. Everybody's going in his own way. So what is the solution? Do we have to try to stop it by force? And say because of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Man ra'a minkum munkaran falyughayyirhu biyadihi." So now this is the solution. If you, first of all, we need everybody to know this, what is going on, how it has begun. So you know, when you know, if you participate in this celebration, then it's up to you. You lost it knowing it. But if you were doing it unknowingly, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiven. If you already know, then you don't have to. What about others who are doing? If you see somebody else who is doing, all you can do is just to educate them, just to tell them how it was with evidences, with clear documentation. You must make reference to all that you have said. Now I've said many things, and I do not give you references because of the timing that you can research. And so when you do that, when you leave alone these people, you don't have to insult them, you don't have to curse them, you don't have to hide. Let them do what they are doing. As long as you have told them, those who are close to you, you give them the advice. Just tell them what's going on. What's going on naturally. We know nowadays all these holidays, Christmas and Happy New Year, all of them were transformed to commercial. It's business now. It's not even about worshiping. It's just business. But if you just give advice to the people, logic advice, if you insult them, then you will fall into the category in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَلَا تَسُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ كَذَلِكَ زَيَّنَّا لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ عَمَلَهُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ مَرْجِعُهُمْ فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says, وَلَا تَسُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Do not insult what the polytheists worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or associate the worship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Lest they insult Allah out of anger or out of ignorance. So if you insult what they worship, then you are automatically the one who causes to be somebody to insult Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't do that. It is forbidden at all. You must approach them politely. Give them respect. And give respect to what they give respect to a certain level. Not that you do the same thing, but show them that you don't mind. You give respect because of humanity. So in that way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, كَذَلِكَ زَيَّنَّا لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ عَمَلُهُمْ. That is why we have beautified every community, for every community we have beautified their actions. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ مَرْجِعُهُمْ فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Then after that, all of them will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then He will tell them and what they were doing, what was right and what was wrong. He will explain to them that. So you have to use your approach to be always wisdom. ادعو الى ربك الى ربك ادعو الى الله سبحانه وتعالى يسوي ادعو الى سبيل ربك بالحكمه والموعظه الحسنه. Call the people in the way to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with wisdom and good admonition. Then when it is that, you have to know that you should not insult and feel like so depressed because of what other people are doing. Just be normal, see it, because that is why you are in a community where most of the people are doing wrong things. That is why you are Muslim, because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was in Medina and Mecca, he was seeing everything going on, and that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained us about the da'wah to spread the Islam. If you see the whole situation is nice and smooth, then there is no da'wah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, كلٌ يعمل ذلك سورة the briefest ayah is in سورة المائدة ayah number 108 and this ayah the one I'm going to mention now is in سورة الإسراء number 87. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says كلٌ يعمل على شاكلتي كلٌ يعمل على شاكلتي فربكم أعلم بمن هو أهدى. Everyone is acting upon his everyone is acting according to his disposition, according to his way. فَرَبُّكُمْ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنْ هُوَ أَهْدَى. And your Lord knows the best who is the most guided. So Allah knows, you don't bother. Like say, somebody is saying to you, Mawlid, it's permissible. Because what I'm doing, I'm only praising the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is wrong if I do that? If I allocate one day in the year, what is wrong? So that person is trying his best. Maybe they have good intention. Maybe they are trying their best. So you don't have to bother them. Just slowly, slowly educate them in a way, informally actually. You educate them informally. While they don't even know where they get the information, it means when you are educating them, just let them know something from different ways. It is all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this religion in a clear way. And anyone who understood it clearly should disseminate it in a way which is the best method. The easiest way to approach people with wisdom, with clear evidence, but not to face them harshly, and not to hate them, and not to yell at anybody. It is just normal that you see people worshiping the sun, people worshiping the fire, people worshiping all that. It has been always like that. And when you see them, all you do is just to show them in wisdom way. Just take an example how Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam has shown them when he first said, okay, let me try the stars. It didn't work. Then, okay, let me try the moon, let me try the sun. And finally he said, how should I add any law people are feeling? I don't want those which are falling down. I want to worship the one who is permanent, not someone that disappears after a few hours. It's all that. If somebody, your friend, says, let's go there, and you respect that person, you should not say, how come you say to me, go to that place, and start like screaming. It's easy that you say, and just like Prophet Muhammad, Prophet Ibrahim, alayhi salam, how he said, when they said to him, come with us, we are going to celebrate for our religious holiday, he said to them, فَنَذَرَ مَثْرَةً فِي النُّجُومِ فَقَالَ إِنِّي سَقِيمٌ. He cast glance at the stars. He looked at the stars and he said, فَقَالَ إِنِّي سَقِيمٌ. Oh, I'm really sick, he said, and laughing. He said, oh, I'm sick, I can't go today. So just make excuse and let them go, then educate them in slowly way, and in a way that is which manner of good ethics. So all we need now is first of all to have the knowledge and then how to approach is to just to be normal and calm, not to be in hurry. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. واقم الصلاة.